Well, for anyone who was a kid in the 80s, rushing home from school to catch Simon Townsend's Wonderworld was part of after-school life. It's been 28 years since the show left our TV screens, so our Craig Bennett caught up with some of the stars who made us laugh and taught us some life lessons. If you believe
anything can happen. And anything could happen for Aussie kids growing up in the 80s watching Simon Townsend's Wonderworld. You belong with me. As Australia's first current affairs show just for kids, Simon Townsend, Woodrow the salivating bloodhound, and his crew of colourfully quirky reporters kept us entertained for nearly a decade. It's the world
we live in. We didn't just do little cutesy pie things that suit children.
It educated you, whether it was the first time you saw INXS or learning about how they make umbrellas.
So it was just an amazing learning curve.
Wonderworld was one of the best experiences of my working life, without a shadow of a doubt.
It was run on the smell of an oily rag. You had to do everything yourself. And sometimes you would be sent out to do a story and you would just be given two words. And you had to make it up as you went along.
A lot of the times you thought of the story on the way to the story.
Angela! And now, 28 years on, we catch up with Simon and some of the reporters that made our lives, well, that little bit more wonderful. Is this how it used to be back in the day of Wonderworld? Fabulous lunches, flowing wine. Hospitality for miles. Moira, you
it
seem to be
me.
Yeah, but you were the boss, Simon, weren't
they're
you?
Not working.
We really didn't know what we were going to do pretty much till the day sometimes, because we had researchers and they would say, this is your assignment, and you'd look at it and it had two words on it, yeah. And you'd go, huh? What? And most of the words were the address. And then you had to get there.
Well, as reporters, we always had to do a story a day. You could not come back without a story.
Let me just give you an example of some of the stuff we guys do.
Oh, my pineapple princess, lovely hula hips.
Who remembers their Wonderworld audition? Because those auditions, Simon, were quite ferocious, weren't they?
Yeah, they were. Thousands of people.
And?
Well, I didn't do an audition. So I was there at the very start of the show. I said, gee, I could probably be a researcher or I could be a sound recordist. And I went in for an interview and they said, we'd like you to be a reporter. What do you think about that?
And what did you think?
I thought, oh, my God.
They were so nerve-wracking. So I wore orange. Back then, orange. So I stood out like a beacon.
I sent my resume out every week for 3 years, from the moment I left school to the moment I got that gig. You ain't nothing but
a hound dog. The reporters may have had a tough time landing a gig on the show, but One Hound was a star from the very beginning.
So I went and got Woodrow when he was a little puppy.
Yes. Really?
Yeah. You did a story on Bloodhounds.
Yeah, on Bloodhounds.
And at the end of the story, it was a little puppy.
That's
all
it.
All on his own. And I said, is that puppy still available?
Yeah.
I'd like to buy it.
That's right.
And then, yeah. To be a family pet.
Yeah.
But he came on the show, just to show people, this is Woodrow, this is my new family.
And everybody loved him.
Everybody in the studio loved him. He talked to the studio fine, and so he became the mascot.
The mascot, that's
I've
right.
I've got a bone to pick with you about Woodrow, though, Simon. Now, back in the day, you and I made a record. It's a vinyl record, Simon Townsend's Bible Heroes, what? Featuring Woodrow and Moira McLean.
Oh, my.
Woodrow didn't hear a bark on the record, but he gets top billing. Just saying, Simon.
I was asked, was I giving him Valium?
Really?
I've been asked that one as well.
Did he seem a bit zonked out sometimes?
Well, sometimes he just falls asleep. He'd rest on the desk.
So Woodrow passed away, and what happened to him, Simon? Where is Woodrow now?
He lasted almost the entire 8 years of Wonderworld, died towards the end. But on the day he died, his front page news in four cities.
Is that so?
Really?
A dog. Yes. The front page news. But people did love him.
Did he get a lot of fan letters?
He got more than me.
What?
Really? And how do you respond? Did you do like the little paw print?
Yeah, we had a paw print.
Really?
You might have noticed there was a bit of an empty seat at that table. Well, our great mate Jono Coleman joins the party after the break, so stay with us for that. We'll have more from the show that changed Aussie TV in the 80s and the man behind it. Studio 10 is back in a tick. Simon Townsend, his bloodhound Woodrow and the gang of quirky reporters taught us all that life is fun and, more importantly, wonderful on Wonderworld. Here is more from the show that helped mould the kids of the 80s.
If there was ever a standout on the show, an absolute scene stealer, it had to be Studio 10's very own Jono Coleman.
And for reasons that I now can't quite remember, falling into the penguin enclosure at Taronga Zoo.
Jono, he's late. Is this a shock to you? No?
Always late.
What was he like back in the days of Wonderworld?
Always late.
Always late?
Always late. He used to always take your pass, your car, park, didn't he?
And get parking in my space. What?
I did it once. Once, a little scrape of his car, that was the second time. First time, just the... I was running late. As you know, I do have a punctuation problem. Punctuality problem.
While Jono's not here, what was he really like to work with? I mean, you can dish, because, you know, I like a bit of gossip.
Of course he was funny and clever and witty, but when I first met him, I said to my producer, look, I like the guy, he's funny and amusing, he's a very nice person, but he's totally uncontrollable. He'll drive us mad.
Even back then?
Nothing's changed. Nothing has changed. Yeah. Oh, folks, for goodness sake.
I like the man.
So glad you could make it.
I was just finishing a story from 1982. Finish the Wonderworld.
That'd be right.
I recognise that shirt.
Yeah, yeah. It's the same shirt I was wearing in 1982.
And he's still wearing it.
I got my reference.
Fantastic.
Says all nice things.
It's quite long, isn't it?
I can't believe you kept that.
You know, I was always late. In fact, I got suspended from Wonderworld twice.
Oh, really?
Like school? I got suspended from Wonderworld twice. I got suspended once because I changed the colour of my hair. Can you believe...
Do that now?
Jonathan Coleman was the linchpin personality.
Linchpin.
In the show's early success.
Yeah, but Angela got the same reference.
I couldn't tell him that then he would have wanted more money.
That's right.
Is that what it came down to, Simon, was it? He wanted more money.
He wanted more money all the time.
It was a long struggle to get Wonderworld on air, but it was finally picked up by Channel 10 back in 1979.
Hello and welcome to Wonderworld.
It was the end of a six-year struggle to get on air.
6 years?
Two pilots and two overseas trips, all sorts of preparation. But 6 years from the day I devised the idea to the day I got on air.
Aimed at tweens, teens and young adults, Wonderworld's reporters would film unscripted stories on anything and, well, everything.
Well, of course, it was animal stories that were our stock in trade, weren't they?
It was a Bible.
Particularly dogs.
Dogs.
No breeder that we did not do a story
that's
on.
Right.
But also...
And weren't they all...
But even if the animal was dead when you got there, you still had to bring back. Harvey, yeah, the parrot's dead. Make something out of it.
Yeah.
To play and slop and slide around in mud.
So I do remember the mud story.
Who discovered this mud hole?
Pico. They were surfies, but it was winter, and they would go to this brick pit and they would put on their wetsuits and they would tip buckets of water down these kind of hills which turned into mudslides. And at the bottom was this big mud pool. It was fantastic! So I borrowed one of their wetsuits and went down. It was like a water slide, except it was down mud. It was just this beautiful, smooth, squishy, slushy mud.
And you got paid
mud.
To do this.
I got paid to do this. It was such a fun story.
Our favourite genre, and it was definitely the animal breeders. They were so quirky.
Probably the stories that I sang in.
Wonderworld also helped launch the careers of some of Australia's biggest pop stars. With the music clip in its infancy, the Wonderworld team broke ground, making the music video for INXS's Simple Simon. Simon.
so like Farnham and Debbie Byrne.
Mark Hunter.
Mark Hunter, Elton John. I was dressed as a bumblebee and I walked into this press conference and Molly's looking at me like, what the hell's going on here? And then Elton said, oh, I know you, I was watching you on TV this afternoon. I'll never forget it, it was like the whole room just went...
Would he have been the biggest star, do you think, on Wonderworld, Simon?
That's pretty
Simon?
Big, yeah.
Just about.
Yeah.
Who were some of the other great legends that featured on the show?
I remember doing Steve Irwin. I'll never forget doing Steve Irwin. Really? And I had to do the whole story of being piggybacked because I was so terrified by all the crocodiles and he just wandered through all the crocodiles. And I thought, well, I need to be with him. How can I join him if I'm terrified? He goes, jump on board. So I did the whole thing being piggybacked, wandering through all the crocodiles, and it made for a great story.
But the show didn't start without its own controversy. The original theme song certainly raised a few eyebrows.
And that was actually produced by John Denver. So Simon would have gone, oh, this is good, John Denver, nice clean cut American boy. There was letters that started coming in saying, are you aware of the fact that Afternoon Delight is about having sex in the afternoon?
So Simon, how long did that first theme run for?
It ran for about 6 weeks before someone told me what it was actually about. If you believe there's
life inside a bubble. The soundtrack is in your head. Yeah. Anyone could just recall it straight away. You belong
with me. What about Simon, your famous catch cry, the world really is wonderful? Where did that come from?
Just one day it occurred to me that I should end the show with a catchphrase. And I thought I should state the obvious. The world really is wonderful. And it sucked.
And you still think that, don't you?
I do.
I propose a toast to Simon Townsend. Oh, and remember, the world really is wonderful because of you, Simon. God bless
you. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
But you can't have a raise. Oh.
The world really is wonderful. Goodbye.
A little piece of Wonderworld on our show every day. Jono Coleman, get in here.
No. Come over here.
Come on, Jono.
It's a little bit sad, actually.
Oh, why?
Because I remember all the people that I used to work with, and a number of people are no longer with us who worked on Wonderworld, like Edith Bliss and Andrew Lesney, one of the original cameramen. So it is, and also with Simon's failing health and everything, it's just a bit emotional. And that's one of the reasons I was late, because I was outside sitting in the car going, do I be funny? Do I be real? Oh, do I be...
Oh, just be your beautiful self, which is what you do every day.
No, I wouldn't have got out of the car then.
But do you ever look back at that, John, and say, you know what, nothing has changed?
he was... we did have good little Barneys and little fights, a little bit like the executive producer on this show once in a while.
Speaking of nothing changing, you still have arguments with our EP about your hair colour. You're always late.
We always
And you also dress up as a bumblebee from time to time.
I know.
Seriously, John, nothing has changed.
Yeah. Oh, my God, it's the bumblebee costume. Yeah, it was weird, though. I did get suspended for changing my... I had GT stripes put in my hair because Sandra Starr, who was still does my hair. She was doing dogs to match their owners. And one of the people that we did, I got my hair changed. And then I also got suspended for numerous other things like parking in Simon's spot.
But, Jono, you know what is so beautiful and wonderful about you is that you are like our morale officer.
Yeah.
You are forever upbeat. You have a kind... thoughtful word for everyone, and you're a joy to work with each day.
Yeah.
So, we love you.
I learned a lot from Simon, and I learned from all the people on that show, and God bless you, Simon. If it hadn't been for you, a lot of people working at 10 and working all over television wouldn't be doing it. So.